Hello students, today we are going to discuss some more concepts based on electrochemistry. Today we will discuss about Nernst's equation as well as we are going to discuss about the topic electrode potential. On the other day we have calculated the electrode potential. We have seen what is electrode potential and how to calculate its value by using SHE. That is standard hydrogen electrode. Today we are going to discuss about cell potential. So the first topic is cell potential. Cell potential is simply defined as the potential difference between the two half cells which we are taking in a redox reaction during electrochemical cell or when we take them in a cell. So cell potential, it is simply defined as the potential difference between the two half cells. So, potential difference between two half cells is called cell potential. Now, next topic we have electrochemical series. Now here, we are moving towards a very very important concept which is known as electrochemical series. Electrochemical series is simply defined as the arrangement of different types of electrodes in increasing value of standard reduction potential. And keep in mind, the standard reduction potentials are calculated by using SHE or NHE. So, we take different kind of electrodes and by using SHE, their reduction potential has been calculated. So, electrochemical series is simply defined as the arrangement of various electrodes in increasing value of standard reduction potentials. Electrodes at which reduction occurs with respect to standard hydrogen electrodes are taken as positive sign. So we say oxidation potential is positive, but reduction potential is negative. Keep in mind that oxidation potential is always equals to negative of reduction potential. So, electrochemical series arrangement of different electrodes in increasing value of standard reduction potential. This thing must be kept in mind that oxidation potential is always equals to negation of, that is negative value of reduction potential. Very important concept. Now, we are going to discuss about the applications of electrochemical series. As we know, in electrochemical series, the electrodes are arranged in increasing order of reduction potential. It means those metals or those elements which are on the top of the electrochemical series has least reduction potential, and which are present at the bottom are strongest. They have a highest reduction potential. So, first is to compare the relative oxidizing and reducing power. Now, positive sign, we know that positive sign of electrode potential indicates greater reduction potential. If greater the positive number, if the value of reduction potential is positive, it means more easily this substance reduces. Substance reduced means it gains the electrons easily. Keep in mind, this substance which has a greater positive value of reduction potential can gain the electron easily. Hence, acts as stronger oxidizing agent. And we can see, if you see the series, electrochemical series in your book, you will find that fluorine is placed at the bottom of the electrochemical series because it has highest reduction potential. It means it is a strongest oxidizing agent. Whereas lithium ions, they are placed on the top of the electrochemical series, indicating that it has lowest reduction potential. It means it has lesser tendency to gain the electrons. So keep in mind, this positive sign of electrode potential always represent greater reduction potential or stronger oxidizing agent. So this is the first application to compare the relative oxidizing and reducing power of different elements. The second application is to compare the relative activities of metals. It means the electrochemical series, it is also used to compare the activity or reactivity of various metals. Those metals which has greater oxidation potential. Keep in mind that oxidation potential is equal to negative of reduction potential. So greater the oxidation potential, more easily a metal can lose the electron, hence greater is the reactivity of the metal. It means those metal which has greater value of oxidation potential can lose the electron easily, and when they lose electron easily, they become more reactive. So you can see here, magnesium is more reactive than zinc, than iron, than copper, than silver. This is the second application of electrochemical series. The third application of electrochemical series is to calculate the standard EMF of a cell. We know that in an electrochemical cell, one is not oxidation half cell and second is known as reduction half cell. And the EMF of a cell can be easily calculated by applying the formula E naught cell equals to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. The value of the cathode and anode, that is E naught, can be easily taken from the electrochemical series. We substitute the value here. Keep in mind, if E naught cell comes negative, it means the cell will not work. E naught cell should always be positive. So in this way, we can easily see where we have used the electrochemical series. Again, let us see. Electrochemical series is used to compare the relative oxidizing or reducing power of various elements or atoms of various metals. Second, it is used to compare the relative activities or relative reactivities of metals. And the third one is to calculate the standard EMF of a cell by applying the formula E naught cell equals to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Now, you can see another very interesting question. Calculate E naught cell. Keep in mind, whenever we solve this type of numericals, we always take reduction potentials. If you see this question here, one very, very important point, that is zinc 2, zinc 2 positive. Is it reduction or oxidation? It's oxidation, because zinc is changes into zinc 2 positive. This is called oxidation potential. Here, E naught Ag2 Ag positive, again oxidation potential is given to us. We have to keep in mind, whenever we solve this type of numericals, we always take reduction potential, and we know the formula how to change oxidation potential into reduction potential. So we know oxidation potential is equals to minus reduction potential. So if we write here E naught, we write it this way, zinc 2 positive to zinc its value is -0.76 volt, and E naught Ag positive to Ag, its value is 0.80 volt. This is oxidation potential, which change into reduction potential. So while solving this type of numerical, you have to be very very alert to check out what is given, because these are minor things which we generally overlook. When this type of question comes, we generally subtract this and this, we get the answer which is absolutely wrong. Check what is given here. If we see the equation, which element is getting oxidized and which is getting reduced? Here zinc changes to zinc positive, and we know the formula, left oxidation anode negative. It means where oxidation takes place, it acts as anode. So it acts as anode, and Ag changes to Ag. Ag positive changes to Ag, it means it is reduction. We know the formula of E naught cell equals to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. So which electrode is cathode and which electrode is anode? Here E naught zinc 2 positive, it acts as anode and it acts as cathode. But values, we have to take these values. Reduction potential. So E naught cathode is Ag positive to Ag. So we write here 0.80 minus 0.76 volt. So its answer is coming 1.56 volt. So the EMF of this cell is 1.56 volt, and this cell exists because E node is positive. So when E node is positive, the cell exists. E node should not be negative. So this is the way how to solve this numerical. Let us discuss some more numericals. Now you can see a question. It is a question which is based on E naught cell. They are saying if nickel changes to nickel 2 positive and copper 2 positive changes to copper, it means nickel get oxidized, copper get reduced. E naught of a cell is 0.59 volt. The standard electrode potential of copper is 0.34 volt. Calculate the standard electrode potential of nickel. Now, one thing always keep in mind, this one is called cell representation. Nickel changes to nickel 2 positive, then double line, copper 2 positive to copper. This side left is oxidation. It means this side is always oxidation and anode. This double line, it represents a salt bridge. And copper 2 positive to copper, it's reduction, and it acts as cathode. If the question comes, write the cell reaction. Let us suppose the question is, write the cell reaction for the given cell. How to write the cell reaction? Nickel is getting oxidized. It means nickel plus copper 2 positive gives nickel 2 positive plus copper. This is known as cell reaction. If they ask, write the cell reaction, then you need to write, otherwise no need. We know the formula of E naught cell equals to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. What is the value of E naught cell? E naught cell is given here 0.59 volt. So 0.59 is equals to E naught cathode, And anode cathode is, anode cathode is given, that is 0.34 minus anode, that is anode. So we bring it here, 0.25 equal to minus anode anode. So anode anode is equals to minus 0.25. That is the value for E naught for nickel half cell. So we have done three applications of electrochemical series along with some numericals. Now we have few more application of electrochemical series. Let us see what are those applications. Now we have two more applications of electrochemical series. The first we have done three. Now the fourth application is to predict whether the metal react with an acid to give a hydrogen gas or not. Generally in the classes like 10, we know that when an acid react with a metal, it produces hydrogen gas. But in some cases, the hydrogen gas is not produced. Instead of producing hydrogen gas, they produce water. So all these values, whether the given metal on reaction with acid produce hydrogen or not, it depends upon electrochemical series. If we calculate E naught of a cell, we know that E naught of a cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. If E naught comes to be positive, it means the hydrogen gas will be released. If E naught comes negative, then the hydrogen gas will not be released by an action of acid on a metal. Similarly, the fifth application says to predict the spontaneity. We must know what is the meaning of spontaneous reactions. Spontaneous reactions are those which takes place by their own. We do not require any external source, or we do not require any external force for the reaction to be carried out. Like when we take a cell, we use the cell directly. We take a cell, put in a watch start working. We are not providing any external energy to the cell. Cell is working by its own, that is called spontaneity. So it also helps to predict whether the redox reaction is spontaneous or not. And the spontaneity depends upon the value of E naught of a cell. If E naught of a cell is positive, then we say the reaction is spontaneous. The reaction takes place by its own without any external source. If E naught is equals to zero, reaction will not take place. Why? Because equilibrium has been reached. We say the reaction is in equilibrium. And if E naught equals to E naught cell equals to zero or less than zero, that means negative. The reaction, that is a redox reaction in an electrochemical cell, does not take place. The reaction do not take place at all. So we have seen the applications of electrochemical series. So with this we will finish off here. Tomorrow we will discuss about the Nernst equation and the uses of Nernst equation to calculate EMF of a cell. Keep in mind E naught cell, that is called standard EMF of a cell, is different from E cell. So that we will discuss, of course, tomorrow. Till the time, you all are requested to just revise the concept what we have done today. and try to solve few numericals based on these concepts. Thank you.